Welcome to Adding Integers. The goal of this video will be to add integers with a number line and also to add integers using rules. Let's start off by defining integers. There's two main ways to define integers. The first way, you can say that integers are the natural numbers listed here, and they're negatives and zero. Or we could say integers are the set of whole numbers that include zero and their opposites. The opposite of zero would still be zero. The important part is that integers are numbers that can be written without a fractional or decimal component and fall within this given set. You can also see the integers labeled here on the number line. There are several ways to illustrate the adding of signed integers. One way is algebra tiles, which I will show in the video entitled Subtracting Integers. But for this video, we'll take a look at adding with a number line. To add a plus b on a number line, we start with a and move according to b. If b is positive, we move to the right. If b is negative, we move to the left. And if b is zero, we stay at a. Let's give it a try. 5 plus negative 7. We will start at positive 5. Since we're adding a negative 7, we move left 7 units. And we end at negative 2. 5 plus negative 7 is equal to negative 2. For negative 2 plus 6, we're going to start at negative 2. And now we're going to move right 6 units because we're adding a positive 6. And we end at positive 4. Negative 2 plus 6 is equal to positive 4. Now this is a nice way to develop the idea of adding integers, but if we go beyond, let's say, negative 10 and positive 10, it really becomes impractical because it takes a long time to sketch a number line and move so many units left or right. I personally like something called the money analogy. You can think of a positive integer as a deposit or money in your pocket, and you can think of a negative integer as a withdrawal or a loss of your money. So here's how it works. 7 plus negative 9. You have $7 because it's positive, and then you lose $9. Well, if you have $7 and you lose $9, you're going to have a loss, and your loss will be a total of $2. 7 plus negative 9 is equal to negative 2. Negative 3 plus 8, you lose $3, but then you win $8. Well, if you lose $3 and then you win $8, you'd still be ahead $5. So it's positive 5. Negative 3 plus 8 equals 5. This next example, negative 8 plus negative 5, you lose $8, and then you lose 5 more dollars, you've lost $13. The sum is equal to negative 13. Hopefully that kind of makes sense. I'd like to pause here and take a look at this example again. Notice how they are both negative. To get the 13, we had to add 8 plus 5, and the sign of our sum stayed the same. On the previous example, when we had a negative and a positive, to get the 5, we actually had to subtract, and the positive kind of outweighed the negative, so we knew our answer would be positive. So to kind of summarize what we're doing here with the money analogy, here's how many textbooks instruct how to add integers. If you're adding two integers of the same sign, add their absolute values, keep the sign of the original integers. The key here is when the integer have the same sign, we add. If you are adding two integers with different signs, you find the absolute value of both, subtract the smaller value from the larger value. The sign of the answer is the original sign of the number with the larger absolute value. So if they're different signs, we have to subtract. Let's give it a try with the help of the money analogy. Negative 25 plus 63. So we're down $25, but then we win $63. So we can probably realize that our sum will be positive, but since the original integers are different signs, we take the absolute value of both. Of course, the absolute value of negative 25 is 25, but since they're different signs, we have to subtract. Again, we knew our sum had to be positive, and in fact, it'll be positive 38. On this next example, we have a loss of $31 and then another loss of $84. Again, we can probably figure out that our answer has to be negative, but since they're the same sign, we take the absolute value of them, and this time we add them. Again, we already determined our sum had to be negative, so our sum is negative 115. The last example, we have a gain of $15, but then we lose $47. Again, it makes sense that our answer would have to be negative, but since these are different signs, we take the absolute value of both, but now we have to subtract. So our sum would be negative 32. I hope that helps explain or review how to add signed integers. Thank you for watching and have a great day.